let us understand how incumbents or traditional industries are navigating through this destabilization phase and giving tough competition to the disruptors in the next panel. In order to understand this, we now invite our next panel, which is moderated by Amrish Dasgupta. Amrish, ex-partner in charge of consulting for PwC and KPMG India, is now a senior partner and founder of Inturi Consulting LLP. He's a senior advisor to Protivity. He's a member of State Public Policy and Planning Board, Government of West Bengal. He holds master degree in electrical engineering from Jadavpur University. He's also the president of Bengal Chamber of Commerce and Industries, chairman of East Asoham and other trade bodies. Amrish?
Before I actually move to the panelists to introduce the topic, I do feel that the present digital disruption that we are going through is far more possibly transformative in nature than what the kind of any other innovations or any other technological cycles that we might have gone through. So it's like if we just go by a quote from Churchill that one damn thing after the other. So in many of the discourses, actually, when we see that people compare this to the World War I, Industrial I, Industrial II, Industrial III, various kinds of revolutions like the steam to the rail to the various kinds of discoveries which have transformed the world. But I think this digital revolution is a far, far more transformative than what we possibly have seen. So it's not like it's not that history is repeating itself. I mean, just to quote Mark Twain, I mean, history rhymes. It doesn't repeat itself, it sometimes rhymes. So it's whether it is rhyming or it's a disruption, whether it is just following itself, but it's definitely a transformative disruption.
I am representing life insurance. I don't think any of you, when you get up from bed, ever think about insurance, forget about life insurance. Probably some of you would be able to talk about which company you have bought it from. 100% sure none of you probably would talk about what is the renewal date. So that's the awareness what I'm coming from. Yeah, is it going to change considering the background of the whole industry? It is not going to change in next 1, 2, 3 years. The point that you just highlighted, there are catalysts that we need to be very, very aware about in this whole industry. I see there are players who are trying to do smart job within the bracket of what is possible in a regulated industry using technology like deep learning, like artificial intelligence. Yeah, without naming those company, but they have started applying it so customer facing in a way that instead of company getting the benefit, the customer also getting the biggest benefit out of it. In a very, very nicer and shorter way, this industry still have not looked into applying these logics in, let's say, actuarial science. When I'm trying to actually underwrite a life, am I trying to underwrite a life based on his behavioral aspect, based on his life expectancy, based on other social aspect? Answer would be somewhere between quantum computing, because it will vary between 0 and 1. So I'm saying there is a huge possibility of using technology and making it much, much more realistic, much, much more price-driven, much, much more value-driven.
Basically, what we would like to understand from you is that you were discussing over the lunch also that from the traditional world, how the digital is shaping your viewerships now, and what are you planning to do in that? So, yeah.
Firstly, I'd like to thank you, Raghu and Kirtana, that they found me worthy enough to come to a campus like Infosys, and Amrish, you found me worthy to even speak here, because I definitely can't talk numbers or technology here. I think the biggest impact is that when I made Kyunki Saas, I was never called to Infosys. The digital disruption, at least I stand a chance to speak here. So I think the most interesting part of digital disruption is a very big positive in our line, because having done the traditional daily soaps, for over 20 years, I worked with Ekta Kapoor for 15 years, almost 15 years, and I think 4 years back when we went to the States, you know, we'd heard this whole Hulu and Netflix and all this coming in, and Ekta was like, I want to do this. And we were like, chalo, you know, like, let her do this on the side. What else is, you know, like, what's, how will that anyways disturb what we are making, the Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi's. But little did we know that there will come a point, which is today, where Alt Balaji is churning out more content than probably Star Plus put together or Star Colors and Zee put together, you know, in terms of the number of hours. So I think it's all good. And the good part is that the smaller players, which never stood a chance, you know, with the GECs. So when I say GECs are the general entertainment channels, which are the big players like Star, Sony, Zee, Colors. So they make, say, 4 hours of original content. You know, you start at 8 o'clock and 11 is when it maxes out. After that, it's all repeat. So how much or how many people can make content for 3 hours on each channel? So the smaller players didn't really have a chance, and they made for the lesser popular channels. And now with the cable TVs also charging for every channel, I think the smaller channels won't stand a chance to even be subscribed to. Digital disruption in our field is actually in, it's opened a lot of doors for all of us. I don't know if anyone of you has even watched any of the Saas Bahu sagas, but I'm sure everyone knows Sacred Games, everyone knows Leela, which is coming with the kind of money all these biggies are putting in promotion.
Actually, digitization was hardly existing. It was, the most of the investments was in R&D and making the drugs and supplying the medicines. It was actually the regulations of different industries which has forced pharma industry to go into significant amount of digitization. And one of the things, like many of you would have read in newspapers and stuff like that, that few years back, many of the pharma companies had this thing called 483, or US FDA having problems with Indian pharma companies. And that was related to data integrity. That means what people were writing in the documents and what was actually there in the different equipments, there might be a disconnect between them. Today we have large factories which makes these pharmaceutical products, and then they are shipped and there is a global supply chain which takes care of it. But 3D printing of medicines, when it happens and people are looking at how to do that, so that would help make small plants at the places where demand is. So so then you would not need these large plants theoretically. But that leads to other challenges and problems. But that would be another thing which needs to be watched out for, where digitization is going to significantly impact the way production of medicines are there and how it is distributed. And also the cost structures.
Going to Gautam, who said that at present not much of a disruption, but anything that is bothering you that you'd like to keep in mind?
My biggest botheration is why not much of disruption. But when I say disruption, see, it's perceived as a negative connotation. There are disruptions happening, but that's so siloed, so small, so minuscule, that it cannot be compared against discovery of the world or against Levenet of the world. When I have to pay a claim to one of my customers, I really don't go back to AI. And that's the problem. When I actually price a life or price a asset in terms of risk, the risk assessment is not based on a model. Yeah. And that's where the disruption is. Rest others are digitization, which we are good or bad, whatever it is. I see digital disruption from a completely different point of view. I see my ability to assess a risk through the digital footprint that he leaves around and assess it correctly for a sustainable time. And I see disruption becomes a reality when the moment of truth comes for him to get a service from me or anybody in the industry, he can get it digitally without any disruption. That's where, to my mind, that's what I want to see.
So thank you very much to everyone for being an attentive listener.
Thank you.
And thanks to my panelists.